You're listening to WNPR, Connecticut's public radio station. Support for NPR comes from NPR member stations and from LendingTree, providing customers with the ability to manage their money, credit, and loans all in one place at LendingTree.com. From the Wallace Foundation, a source of ideas for expanding learning opportunities beyond the school day at WallaceFoundation.org. And from Carnegie Corporation of New York, a foundation created to do what Andrew Carnegie called real and permanent good, celebrating 100 years of philanthropy. This is NPR.
Our funding comes from our members and from the Montessori School of Greater Hartford, providing the best possible start for children 15 months to 12 years. Nurturing a passion for learning and for life in a diverse, independent school setting. Tours begin November 9th in West Hartford, 860-236-4565. Cloudy today, a 40% chance of rain, a high near 46. It's 7:30.
Good morning, I'm Steve Eskew. Reynolds Smith Jr. spent a lifetime as a loyal Democrat, head of the party, followed him one more time. The Alabama State Democratic Party was having a dispute with Democrats in Mobile County. Mr. Smith could help. In this case, the party appointed him to the county executive committee. There's no problem. Officials laid an outdated voter list for the mistake of appointing Mr. Smith, who died and is being free.
From the NPR News in Washington, I'm Gina Cochran. Most economists expect a lack of inflation to be reflected in the consumer price index report. The price is ticking upward in September. With flat inflation this year, or the year, expected to translate to a zero cost of living increase for the nation's senior citizens, the Social Security Administration is due out with an announcement today as well. President Obama is asking Congress to give senior benefits with another $250 payment. That would be equal to a 2% increase from the average Social Security recipient. The latest report.